This question is an example of what you might find on an organic chemistry exam where the professor is trying to tease out whether you know how to apply the systematic rules for naming organic compounds, particularly hydrocarbons or alkanes. So it might be tempting in this case to look at this molecule and say, well, that's the longest chain, so that's going to be where I start my naming. However, the first rule is to identify the parent chain. And although this is how we would normally draw a molecule with the longest chain horizontally like this in a zigzag conformation, the professor may be wanting to trick you by drawing the molecule in an unusual way and getting you to not apply those systematic rules. So let's just number that chain first from left to right like this. And we end up seeing that it's a 7-carbon chain. And then we want to look for, are there any other possible chains that are longer than that? So if we number going out this way, we get to an 8-carbon chain. So that is going to be, that's a longer chain, so that's going to be a parent chain. I don't think we're going to find any other possibilities here. We could also go out to this methyl group here. That would be number 8. So those two there are identical, so we could choose either one. It doesn't matter. We'll end up with the same name either way. Okay, so the second step in our rules is to identify the substituents. So what I'm going to do is highlight that longest chain, like so. And we want to see what are the substituents attached to this molecule. So we've got here a methyl. And here we have another methyl. Or you might say methyl. It depends on what part of the world you're from. In Australia, we tend to say methyl ethyl, a sort of a short sound, but you might say ethyl or methyl. And here we've got a 2-carbon chain, so that is an ethyl or ethyl group. Okay, so we've got 3 substituents, 2 of which are methyl groups and 1 of which is ethyl. Now, before we put in any prefixes to these, like di, tri, tetra, and so on, we can alphabetize these, and ethyl is going to come before methyl. So we're going to have a molecule that's going to have ethyl as part of the name, and then something, and then we're going to have 2 methyl groups, and when there's 2 of the same group, we put di in front of that, so this is ethyl something dimethyl, and then we need to put in numbers into the name to indicate where they are on that chain. To do so, we need to name this chain, or number this chain, so that we get to the first substituent as quickly as possible. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to scratch out these numbers here, and we're going to number the chain again so that we get to the first substituent as quickly as possible. Now, with complex molecules, you might want to have 2 goes at this and just go for the one that gets you to the desired result. So there's my longest chain again. So if we do this by trial and error, we might just go left to right first. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now that will get us to the first substituent at the 5 position. If we number from the other direction though, we would be going in red now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And now we're getting to the first substituent at the 2 position. So that numbering scheme is going to win. So in this case, this will be numbered according to these red numbers, starting from the right-hand side and working towards the left. Okay, so now we can start putting our name together for this molecule. Okay, so we're going to assign a locant, which is the number that says what position along the parent chain each substituent is located at. So let me use blue again. We've got a methyl group at the 2 position. We've got a methyl group at the 3 position here. And we've got an ethyl group at the 4 position. So don't get caught out by using your wrong numbers. You might want to, if you're doing this in an exam, use an eraser to get rid of the numbers that you've tried at first and just keep the ones that are correct for the numbering scheme that we've settled on. Okay, so we've got a 4 ethyl group. And now we're going to group these substituents together. We've already done that. We've said that it's dimethyl and just a single ethyl. So it'd be ethyl, something rather, dimethyl. So then we put them with their numbers at the front. So we're going to have 4 ethyl and then a dash. So we always separate the locants, these numbers, from the substituent name by dashes. And now we've got dimethyl. We've got one in the 2 position, one at the 3 position. So it's going to be 2, 3, and then a dash dimethyl. Okay, and then finally, the parent is an 8-carbon chain. So 8-carbon chain, the parent is derived from oct. And because it's just an alkane, it's going to be octane. So this is octane here. And it's really important we don't put a space in between the end of the substituents and the parent chain name itself. It may look a bit funny when you first start doing this, all squished together like that, but that's the correct way to do it. And you'll very often see people make this mistake where they put another dash in or they put a space in, but to be absolutely correct, you don't put anything in at all. You just squish together the last letter of the substituents with the first letter of the parent chain.